Then you can type your attendance now. Okay. Then now we are going to start our fourth chapter, that is practical geometry. Did you heard about geometry? Yes, we know that what is geometry. And for studying geometry, we have a geometrical box or geometrical kit and so etc. We have some geometrical instruments, is it? That is compass, scale, protractor, set square and so on. We have some geometrical instrument. And in this chapter, it is as a continuation of our third chapter. That is, in our third chapter, we have discussed about quadrilaterals. And here, we are going to construct some quadrilaterals. We are going to study how to construct quadrilaterals. In this chapter, we are going to study how to construct quadrilaterals. And there are five ways in which we are going to construct quadrilaterals. We have five ways for constructing quadrilaterals. That's only we have studied in this chapter. That is, this is a very small chapter. That's why we are deciding to conduct exam for fourth and third chapter and fourth chapter together after completing our this chapter. So you don't have an exam on this Saturday. That would be postponed after completing the practical geometry also. Okay. Okay. Then first of all, we are going to study how to construct quadrilaterals. And in your textbook page number 58, you can see that there are five cases given. That is, first case, when four sides and one diagonal are given. First case, when four sides and one diagonal are given, how will we construct a quadrilateral? And the second case, when two diagonals and three sides are given. When two diagonals and three sides are given. And the third case, when two adjacent sides and three angles are given. Two adjacent sides and three angles are given. And also the fourth case, when three sides and two included angles are given. Three sides and two included angles are given. And the last case, when other special properties are known. Using some special properties. So we have to construct quadrilaterals in this different five methods. First of all, in the beginning of this chapter, there is a do this exercise for you. That is, you know what happens when we construct a quadrilateral. That is, you just assume that this is a quadrilateral. This is not a quadrilateral. You just assume that this is a quadrilateral. This is now a quadrilateral, is it? Okay. Now, what is the shape according to this quadrilateral? This is a rectangle, is it? This is a rectangle. And when I am just changing this into left-hand side, what happens? I am just changing this shape into left-hand side. What happens? It becomes a parallelogram, is it? It becomes a parallelogram. And similarly, when we transform into other side also, it again become a parallelogram. That is given in this do this box. That is, take a pair of sticks or equal length. We have to take stick of equal length. I don't have sticks here. That's why I'm choosing this wire. Okay. So, using these sticks, we can construct rectangles and the parallelogram. So, we only need to get the sides of a quadrilateral or a parallelogram or a rectangle, then we can construct that quadrilateral by only getting the four sides. That is only given in this do this box. You can just read it out after the class, okay? You can just read that. It's very simple sentence and you will get it very fast. It's very simple. That is the only thing that is described there, that we are constructing a quadrilateral and changing it into a parallelogram. That's the only thing described there. and next session, that is our first session of this chapter, is constructing quadrilaterals. We are going to construct quadrilaterals in many ways. That is the first way, when the length of four sides and diagonals are given. When the length of four sides and diagonal are given, we have given that four sides of a quadrilateral and the diagonal. Then we have to construct. We have to construct a quadrilateral. Before that, I am just going to share my screen and you will get a video. After watching that video, we have to discuss the construction. Okay. Okay, I'm just going to share my screen. Can you see the video?
Yes. Okay.
Then here we have the sides, four sides and one diagonal is given. That is four sides, 4 cm, 7 cm, 5 cm and 5.5 cm. These are the four sides of a quadrilateral, and the diagonal EG, that is 8 cm, is also given. This is our first case, that is when length of four sides and diagonal are given. First of all, we have to draw a rough sketch without choosing its length, actual length. First of all, we have to draw a rough sketch. Here we have drawn a rough sketch of this quadrilateral. We don't know this is the exact shape of our quadrilateral. We have just drawn a rough sketch. Okay. So first of all, we are going to construct this quadrilateral. We have the length of its four sides and one diagonal are given. So let's look at how they are going to construct a quadrilateral. First of all, the length of the diagonal. What is the length of the diagonal? 8 cm. First of all, using the scale, we are choosing the length of our diagonal. In this case, four sides and one diagonal is given. And first we have to choose the length of our diagonal. That is 8 cm. That is, here we have drawn the 8 cm. That is our diagonal. And after that, we have to draw the side. We have to draw the side EF. We have to draw the side EF. For drawing the side EF, what is the length of EF? What is the length of EF? 4 cm, is it? This is the same question given in your textbook. You can see here. This is the same question, example 1. So, what is the length of EF? Only the names is given as little different. Here PQRS and here it is chosen as EFGH. The measurement and a little bit different. That is, instead of 7 cm, in your textbook it is 6 cm. That's the only difference here. The other, and the diagonal is also 7 cm, in our textbook it is 8 cm. Okay, that's the only difference. Similarly, we are going to construct this quadrilateral. So first of all, we have drawn the diagonal. What is the length of the diagonal in this video? 8 cm. So first of all, using scale, we are going to draw a diagonal 8 cm long. And after that, we have marked the both edges, that's the names of their edges, that is E and G. Okay. And then we are going to begin with the edge E, or the vertex P, sorry, E. So what is the length of EF? In this figure, we have given the length of EF as 4 cm. Okay, so for drawing this 4 cm, we have to take a compass. We have to take a compass, and using scale, we have to measure 4 cm on our compass. We have to make a measure of 4 cm on our compass. And after that, putting this sharp edge at E, we have to make arc. Let's here in this video they are doing by choosing 4 cm they are going to edge E and they are making an arc. Okay, they are making an arc of radius. This is a part of the circle having radius 4 cm. That's because we need a line of length 4 cm. And on the other edge G, what is the length of GF? What is the length of GF? It is 7 cm, is it? It is 7 cm. So again, we are using our compass, and in our compass, we are measuring 7 cm. In our compass, we are measuring 7 cm, and similarly, we are going to draw an arc. Okay, we are going to draw an arc. So now we get the point of intersection, that is the point F. Which is the point F? This is the point F. So here now we get a triangle, is it? Now we are joining them, we will get a triangle there. That is triangle EGF. We will get the triangle EGF. Okay, similarly, we have to construct the triangle EGH also. In the same way, how will you construct the triangle EGH? For that, first of all, we have to take our compass again and measure the value of EH. We have to get two edges, that is F and H. And now, Sean, do you have any doubt? Okay. Next, we are going to construct the side EH. Then what is the length of side EH? What is the length of the side EH? 5.5 cm, is it? So, we are going to take 5.5 cm in our compass. Okay. Then, using 5.5 cm, we are just drawn an arc. Taking 5.5 cm, we are just going to draw an arc. Look at the video, 5.5 cm, we have drawn an arc. And again, we have to draw the side GH also. Then what is the length of the side GH? 5. So again, our compass would measure the length 5 cm. So using the compass, we are measuring 5 cm and making another arc. Okay. Okay, did you get the idea? Here is also we get the point of intersection, which is H. And now we are going to join this H with both the points E and G. Okay, by joining them, we will get the quadrilateral EFGH. That is, now we get the quadrilateral EFGH. Did you get the idea of constructing a quadrilateral when the length of 4 sides and a diagonal are given? Did you get this idea? Okay, it's very simple, is it? Okay, I'm going to show once more. You just see this video very carefully once more, okay? First of all, we are given 4 sides and one diagonal. That is, we are going to construct it. For that, first of all, we have drawn a diagonal here, and using one edge, we are going to make arc. And similarly, from the other edge, we are going to mark the arc. And then we will get the point of intersection, which is F. Then by joining F with the other two edges, we will get a triangle. And similarly, what we can do? Similarly, the other triangle can be constructed in the same way. That is, for that we are going to construct or mark the edge H. For that we are going to measure the scale and then marking the arc. From that we will get the point of intersection, which is H, which is the edge H. And by joining this edge H with the E and G, we will get the quadrilateral EFGH. This is the way through which we construct a quadrilateral while we are known the length of four sides and a diagonal. Did you get the idea of constructing a quadrilateral when the four sides and the one diagonals are given? Okay, then using this we have to construct some quadrilaterals. For that you have four different values are given. First of all, quadrilateral ABCD, then quadrilateral JUMP, then parallelogram MORE, and last rhombus BEST. Here what we have given, the length of the sides and one diagonal is given. Using this we have to construct that quadrilateral. Did you able to construct that quadrilateral using the given measures? Can you do that? Okay, then that is exercise 4.1, first question. You can draw it in your rough book now. Take your rough book or the back side or in the rough paper. Okay, that's fine. You can construct it as your rough work. Okay, then first of all we have to draw a quadrilateral ABCD. I am just going to draw a rough sketch of that quadrilateral ABCD. Okay, I am just going to draw a rough sketch of that quadrilateral ABCD. This I am just going to name this as ABCD. This is only the rough sketch. You should draw or construct it with the scale and the compass. Okay, first of all we have drawn a rough sketch of the quadrilateral ABCD, and we have known that what is the length of AB. Length of AB is given as 4.5. is given as 4.5 centimeter. And what is the length of BC? Length of BC is equal to 5.5 centimeter. And what is the length of CD? The length of CD is 4 centimeter. And the length of AD is 6 centimeter. And one diagonal is also given, that is length of AC. First of all, we have to draw a diagonal, that is we have to connect A and C. The length of AC, what is the length of AC is given? 7 centimeter. The length of AC is given as 7 centimeter. So now we are going to construct this parallelogram, sorry, quadrilateral using compass and scale. Then we have learned how to draw this quadrilateral. First of all, what we have to do here? First of all, we have to draw our diagonal. Sit. First of all, we have to draw our diagonal. How will you draw this diagonal? Using scale, you can draw a line of 7 centimeter. Long. Okay. You just draw a line of 7 centimeter long in your rough book. That is, it's
name is AC. The line AC having length 7 cm. Okay, first of all, we have to draw a line of length 7 cm. That is AC. Did you draw the line? Okay, just. Okay, then what we have to do next? What we have to do next? First of all, we have to mark the edge B, is it? Or the vertex B. For marking the vertex B, we have to take 4.5 cm in your compass. 4.5 cm in your compass. Did you take 4.5 cm in your compass? You just take 4.5 cm in your compass. Okay, then marking our sharp edge here, by pointing our sharp edge at A, you just have to mark arc. You just want to mark arc by pointing on A. Okay. Then similarly, now we have to take 5.5 cm in your compass. 5.5 cm, that is the length of BC. The length of BC. You have to take 5.5 cm in your compass. After taking 5.5 cm, place the sharp edge at C and then make an arc of arc like this. You will get an arc like this. Is it? Then what is this point of intersection? This point of intersection represents the edge B. Okay. Now we are going to join our point of intersection with the two vertices, that is vertex A and vertex C. Now we will get a triangle ACB. Did you get the triangle ACB? Did you get the triangle ACB?
Yes.
Okay. Then similarly, we have to draw the triangle ACD also. How will you draw the triangle ACD? For that, first of all, we have to take 6 cm. Okay, Anne Maria. First, we have to take 6 cm in your compass. First, you have to take 6 cm in your compass. You just take 6 cm in your compass. Okay, after taking that 6 cm, you just place the sharp edge at A and mark an arc like this by pointing the sharp edge on A. You just mark an arc like this, which of length 6 cm. Okay.
Miss.
Yes.
Miss A ilano point sharp edge.
We have to point on A because the length of AD is 6 cm. We are going to draw the length 6 cm or the side AD. That's why we are pointing on A. By pointing on A, we have to mark an arc of length 6 cm. Okay. Then similarly, what is the length of CD? The length of CD is 4 cm. That's why we have to choose 4 cm in your compass. We have to choose 4 cm in your compass. By choosing 4 cm in your compass, you can draw an arc by pointing on C. By pointing on C, which is like this. By pointing on C, we can mark an arc like this, and then we will get an point of intersection which can be represented as the edge D. This is D. Now we will get the 4 edges, and now we have to join AD and DC. After getting the point of intersection, you just have to draw lines between AD and CD. Okay, now we will get the quadrilateral ABCD of the given length. Okay, Sean. Okay. Now we will get the required quadrilateral. Is it clear? The drawing of quadrilateral is very simple, is it? Okay. Then there are 3 more questions for you. First one, the second one and fourth one, you can do it as your homework. Second one and fourth one. Third one will draw now. That is parallelogram. In page number 60, exercise 4.1, in the first question that we are drawn now, and we are going to draw the third one now. Okay. That is, first of all, here also we have to draw a rough sketch. That is, we have to draw a parallelogram. We have to draw a parallelogram. What's the name of the parallelogram? M-O-R-E. Don't read it as more. It is M O R E. M O R E. And the values given here are, what is O R? The length of O R is, the length of O R is 6 cm. The length of OR is 6 cm. And the length of RE. The length of RE. What is the length of RE? 4.5 cm. The length of RE is 4.5 cm. And EO. EO means the diagonal or OE. What is the length of the diagonal given here? The length of the diagonal is 7.5 cm. So first of all, we have to draw this rough sketch. And we know that the properties of a parallelogram, then opposite side should be equal. Then what is the value of OM? What is the value of OM here? Is it 6? OM is the opposite side of RE. Then the length of OM should be 4.5 cm. And also the length of ME should be 6 cm. That's because it's a parallelogram. Okay. So, first of all, what we have to do here? First of all, we have to draw our diagonal. Okay, what is the length of our diagonal? The length of our diagonal is 7.5 cm.
7.5 cm.
Okay, first of all, we have drawn a diagonal of length 7 cm whose name is OE. And similarly, now we are going to choose 6 cm on our compass. OR. the length of OR is 6 cm or OM. The length of OR is 6 cm. Now we are going to construct the side OR. For that we are choosing 6 cm in your compass, and by placing or pointing at O, we are just going to draw an arc like this. Is it? We are choosing the length of OR, that is 6 cm in your compass, and pointing at O, we are just drawing our arc by pointing at O. Okay, and we know that the same length 6 cm is given for ME. So without changing the measure at your compass and pointing at E, you can mark an arc like this. Okay, without changing the length, because the sides are equal. And similarly, now we are going to choose 4.5 cm in your compass. 4.5 cm in your compass. You just take 4.5 cm in your compass. After taking 4.5 cm in your compass, first you have to place it in E. You have to place it in E and mark an arc like this, 4.5 cm. Then this point would be, arc. Yes.
Yes. Amolte mark edittile adu oil vechittano e il vechittano
ee, that is the measure of ME is 6 cm. That's why we have marked here 6 cm long by placing at E. Okay, then now we will get the length of R, and in your compass the measure should be 4.5 cm as remains. So by placing at O, you can draw an arc like this here. By placing at O of length 4.5 cm. Then this point of intersection should be the vertex M. Now by joining the other sides, we will get the parallelogram MORE. MORE. If it is not a parallelogram, you just assume that it's a parallelogram. You will get the correct shape. Here I'm not using the compass, that will affect my shape. Okay. Okay. Now we will get the shape of a parallelogram. So we have constructed the parallelogram MORE. So today we have learned the construction of a quadrilateral when four sides, okay Sean, when four sides and one diagonals are given, we have learned how to construct a quadrilateral. How will you construct a quadrilateral when a diagonal and four sides are given? First of all, we have to draw the diagonal. And before that, we have to draw a rough sketch. Okay. First of all, we have to draw a rough sketch and mark the measures on that rough sketch. And using that rough sketch, first of all, we have to draw the length of the diagonal. And using the length of the diagonal, we have to choose the length of the sides in your compass and place at appropriate edges. Okay, by placing at appropriate, yes, Sean?
Yes, exercise 4.1 le first tale edike homework varne.
Exercise 4.1 le 2 and 4. Quadrilateral JUMP and rhombus BEST. Okay, then after drawing arcs, we will get the point of intersection of that arcs, and that intersection point of intersection will be our other two edges and joining the other edges with the our first edges, we will get the parallelogram or quadrilateral or rhombus or etc. So on. Okay. Did you get the idea of constructing a quadrilateral when four sides are given and one diagonal is given? It's very simple, is it? Okay. In this chapter, there is only the same concept is repeating. That is the different five cases in which first case we have learned. There are four more cases for constructing quadrilaterals that we have to learn in our next classes. Okay. And after completing this lesson, we have to conduct an exam for the third and fourth chapter together.